So how do you think you resolve that? Because how do you look at the situation and go, okay, one, considering what you just said there, that issue there, where how you resolve someone else who isn't committing crimes and isn't receiving any opportunities and any help. Yeah. But at the same time, knowing that if you're in a position of governing a place and you go, we have these laws, these rules that people have to follow. Mm-hmm. Like, you just can't steal people's stuff. You just can't. There has to be some sort of consequences. Mm-hmm. And also, just part of it is just containment. Knowing like, hey, this person over here has decided that they know the law, they know the rule, and they know they're not allowed to do, they can't hurt other people, and they don't care. They still say to themselves, I am going to. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't feel like I need to follow these rules. I can take other people's belongings. I can hurt other people if I want to. And unless they can stop, if they can stop me. But if they can't, well then, what are you going to do about it? Well, we can't just allow that person to run rampant, as we see in situations in Oregon where, you know, they kind of had created a little area. They said the police weren't allowed, and now people are leaving that area because people are getting raped and murdered because no one's there to enforce consequences on actions. Mm-hmm. And so then it becomes what people kind of fear and worry that society can fall apart into, which is that whoever is the strongest and has the ability to defend themselves is the safest and can take whatever they want. And if you can't defend yourself, and this, you know, what's interesting, this ties into so many conversations in the world today, because this ties into, you know, people talking about Black Lives Matter, talking about Blue Lives Matter, All Lives Matter. People make all these statements, right? Started off, you know, talking about how police are dealing with the minority communities, and then other people respond in kind with, oh, you know, Blue Lives Matter, oh, you know, and then there's defund the police, and then there's back the blue, and all these things. And then at the same time, it goes into people talking about people who believe in guns rights versus who don't believe in guns rights. And people who believe in guns rights would say similar things, which is, well, you know, what occurs in that situation. I can't, you know, I walk in a situation where a group of people over here decide they're going to take what I have with my bare hands, I'm in trouble, right? But if I have a weapon, I can equalize the numbers, right, and defend myself. And so people don't want, you know, we don't want society to fall in that. Into that. So we have to kind of enforce at the most just protecting people in a society. So what do you think is the resolution, is the answer there? How do we considering all of that, right? Were you in a position, not that you're running and you want to, and listen, I think any sane person would really desire to be like in the country in the way it is now, be running the country, because it's you see what occurs to the presidents, like just 4 years and they gain like 12 years. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? 12 years of life, like, it takes a lot out of a person, and it's an exhausting thing. And then mostly, you know, like, really, you know, the people who really have a desire, you see the kind of people that have a desire to be in politics, and they're really not making a lot occur. They're really not accomplishing a lot of things. But were you in a position to change that? What do you think is the solution, man?
It starts with character. And so some principles, there might be a conversation concerning, but there's a lot of principles that we hold in common. And I think that's a great place to start, the principles that we hold in common. And then to realize that everybody has a right to be respected, which means those principles apply to everybody without exception. I think that's a great place to start. Right? So as much as I have the right to not have my life taken, and to have my life disrupted without serious rationalization and justification just being a root word of that in some legal matter, every other person has that same right, and not allowing for any exceptions to be made concerning that, whereby a conflict then can be created. I think that's the way forward in creating peace out of chaos. So what principles do we have in common? Let's start there. Let's make sure that we're applying them equally to everyone, regardless as to background or creed or so forth. But to the extent that the creed doesn't, you know, once again, go into moral matters. But now, as for the people who had objections, understandably, to a person who would receive opportunities that they feel like they're having to work hard for, I think it ties into that idea of showing respect for everyone. That respect takes different measures dealing with different people, and sometimes different groups of people, the different needs and problems that might exist there, that in us addressing shows our care and concern for them, and the different things that come forth are going to be different based on the circumstances present. You know, so one way that the poverty for them might have been addressed is employment, and that employment came in the form of them getting a penal system or a correctional center that's designed to try to help someone else, at least in its intent, it's designed to try to help someone else, to reform someone else. Now that the person is in there, are we not supposed to have some kind of programs geared towards achieving that goal, or just going to be more empty words? The same thing that got us in this position to begin with, people saying something and doing nothing. You know, and if you think it shouldn't have anything, so that there's an even greater potentiality than what might already exist for the person to leave out the same as, if not worse than he came in, here's an idea. He's probably indigent and can't take care of himself, right? And so if nothing else, we're going to give him government assistance. We're going to give him a voucher to let him get a home, and we're going to let him move next to you. How about that? And if you wouldn't want that, don't do that to someone else, because he's going to live next to someone else. He's going back to some community, even if it's not yours. No, so I think the care and concern we show for everybody is doing everything we can to help someone to become a better person when they're obviously experiencing challenges with regard to that. And the more challenged, the more care we should show. And so I'm all for the programs that exist, the opportunities that exist inside of the correctional centers. But once again, well-rounded education is what leads to a well-rounded and sound individual, and any sound education also has to have a moral component. Right. You have to have the conversation about morals at some point in order to instill a value for them within the individual, so it's more than just what his grandmother taught him, or more than just what he heard coming forth from somebody who was a spiritual leader, you know, on television or in the community. He has to see the use for those principles in achieving what he would like to have in his life, and understand why it's important for other people to have the benefit of having them at work to protect and to promote their lives as well.